Hello guys, HG Gaming here, and today I'm gonna show you guys this cool mod that I just got, and I will show you guys installation and how to download it and install it correctly. So if you guys want to just skip to that part, then you guys can do that, but I'm going to show you guys the gameplay of it and what everything looks like. I will put a time thing in the description or comments so you guys could just skip to the tutorial if you feel like doing that. But what this does, it basically makes everything more a lot brighter. By brighter, I mean the lights are a lot more brighter. So tail lights, reverse lights, headlights, the lights on top of a police car, and lamps. Anything that basically glows in the game, or should glow, basically will be brighter. So I'll see you guys in the game. Alright, so I am now in game, so let's just wait for everything to spawn back up. Alright, there you go. So there's the lamp when you spawn in Franklin's house. Or if you're still at the beginning of the game like me, you should see the lamp. If it's nighttime for you. But I'm gonna go change the time to midnight so you guys can see the lights a little more better. And you will see across the street, the three white lights are pretty bright, and so is the street lights too. So it is a pretty cool thing. So I'm going to go ahead and spawn my police car, show you guys it, show you guys the lights and everything. And here we go. I've noticed when the vehicle is parked or turned off, I noticed the running lights are on. That's something that I think was added, but you will see that the tail lights and reverse lights are brighter. The police computer is also brighter. The police computer will only be shown if it's actually originally on. But this is basically what it looks like. It's really cool. I would recommend getting it. So, I'll see you guys in the tutorial. Alright guys, so now that we're back, let's go ahead and open up our browser. And I will link this down in the description below, as I did say a few minutes ago. But anyway, once this opens up, click the download this file button. And it should pop up with a captcha as well. So in my case it's not going to because I went back, as you see right there. But and yeah, that happened. After you get the file, I'm going to go ahead and open up mine. So this is what it should look like. It should look like a zip file, even though it does not open up in 7-zip or WinRAR. But make sure you click the Radiance V. So you do have a few files. Right here, this picture is the installation and some other important stuff, but I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys this stuff. So you do have your settings right here. So this, you will need either PostFX on high or above, I believe. Anywhere higher or above to be able to use this. I've never used it before and I don't know what it does. So just in make sure my game does not break, I did not install these at all. But you guys can go ahead and try those out for yourself and tell me what it does, because I am really curious. And I just don't want my game to break because I already had that happen. Okay, so the one, what we're going to be messing with is visual settings. So we have two settings, we have bright and very bright. I'm using very bright, as I said sometime in the video. So right here you do you have like two files. So in this one I'm using the amber brake parking lights. I'm not quite sure what it does, what the difference between this visual settings .dat or the amber parking lights. And I did notice he spelled lights wrong, which is kind of interesting. But so just go ahead and drag the visual settings .dat onto your desktop. I already have one, but I'm gonna go ahead and replace mine. Make sure you back up your files before doing this, so in case something does go wrong, you could still fix your game up. So, see where my files are. After that, you will need OpenIV. I'll link that in the description below for you guys to go ahead and get. And, okay, so the steps to get to this is update that RPF, comment, data, and it should bring you to it. And then you will see visual settings.dat somewhere along this page, sometimes on the bottom, because yours might be in alphabetical order if the first time you're using this, but mine is not. So make sure you click edit mode so you're able to edit all the files in this area. Then click the plus sign. And then you could type in your visual settings.dat or just type in V right here and you might be able to find it. But sometimes that may not happen if you have already another V in front of it. So make sure you just click open. And the kilobytes should change from what it was originally. If not, then I have no clue why it's not doing that. You may have did it wrong, or it's named incorrectly. But it should have changed in kilobytes. So you know it worked if it did. So basically this is it. You can mess around with the other settings. I'll show you guys a few pictures of what it will look like. This will open up. This is a really cool picture. I like how this guy did take it. But yeah, this is what it will look like. It should look like for you, at least. So, if this helped you out, please smash that like button. I'll see you guys later.